Hello. I wanted to do an update on these seedlings that we've planted and also show you some tips on caring for them. This is our seedlings after we planted them. They need to get plenty of light, and these ones are getting about 4 or 5 hours of direct light a day and then pretty bright light the rest of the day. And I'm going to show you a few of the stages here as these seedlings are growing up. They usually sprout anywhere from 12 hours to a couple days after you plant them. These are just 2.5 days old, and you can start to see some roots forming and various seedlings coming out of their seed. So one thing you want to do as you're caring for these seedlings is make sure they don't dry out. I like to water them from the bottom, and it's okay if there's a little bit of water that stays at the bottom of the tray that they're in for a while. Usually I'll let just a little bit stay in there, and then after it dries out, I refill it again. You don't want those peat pellets to dry out completely or your sprouts will die at this stage, but you also don't want them just sitting in water 24 hours a day, because then they can get fungi problems and start to rot. Here I'm adding some mycorrhizal inoculant to these. I'm not sure if this is making a difference at this point. I've never added it this early on, but I didn't add it to all of them, and it seems like the ones that I did add it to do have a little bit different root structure. So this doesn't have any of the fungi, and this one does. You can see this root is larger. I don't know if that's from the fungi or not, but it's kind of interesting and something I'll keep monitoring. Here I wanted to show you, I did get a couple of seeds transferred accidentally rather than just one in a few of these pods, so I'll show you how to take these out and just kind of use a I'm just using a paring knife just to kind of tease them apart. It's not really to cut them or anything. It's just to help to get those roots apart, and then it helps to transfer them also. I was doing this one-handed too, so because I was recording, so it made it a little more difficult, but you want to be really gentle so you don't hurt those tiny little roots or damage that little sprout. After you take them apart, you can just kind of lightly put the soil back around them so they're standing up. Just transfer the other one straight over to an empty peat pellet, and again just put some peat around it, just being careful not to hurt those little roots. Normally I wouldn't be doing this in the sun, but it's kind of good lighting for filming these, and they were fine. It's not hot here at all. It's pretty cool days lately. Well, that's it. So you can see the growth of them over the first few days, and you can see a couple of tips. Basically, just keep them wet. Don't leave tons of water in them or the roots might start to rot, but that's all for me today. Thank you, everybody.